So a couple of helpful hints. I mean, photos are always the biggest thing people talk about. What are we going to do about preparing? And I love to tell people that all of my photos are in photo albums. I put them all in the car, and we cannot fit in the car. So photo albums are not necessarily the answer to this. So a lot of people are going digital. And it's easier because so many of us have digital cameras, but then we have this backlog of previous photos that have not been digitized. And so many of the scanners now offer really good optical recognition so that you can scan your photos in. A lot of the local businesses do scanning. And so the easiest way of transport, of course, is a digital CD of the photos that you have. And then you can actually use a three-ring binder to keep those CDs in, so it's compact and all in one place and easy to carry. If you decide to go another route, you can have archival boxes. There's lots of companies that offer archival products where things are consolidated. Mm-hmm. And then you can make copies of the most precious of your photos that way by digitizing and then printing out a copy so you have multiple copies. Books and videos. A lot of people are very attached to their books, so again, you want to be sure you pick the ones that are most important to you. Think about what can't be replaced and tag it. You know, a lot of us, when we prepared for Rita, we took photos off the pictures off the wall and books and put them into bags, and some people still have those things in their bags and have never put them back on the shelf, but just place them in an easy to retrieve spot so they're all together, mm-hmm. so you don't have to be looking around for them. Medical, we talked a little bit about. It is very important to have a first aid kit that's up to date, that goes in your car with you or that stays at home. There's a manual that's available from the American Red Cross on treating emergencies. And then you want to think about stocking your medicine cabinet for those situations that are just out of the ordinary, such as, you know, just the antibacterial cream, surgical mask and gloves, which sounds really weird, but if your home is flooded because of the different bacteria, you're going to want to have gloves. And then anything that has to do with your personal medical needs. And again, you can, in some cases, duplicate some of that. Transportation. It's funny that you would not think about how important keeping your car well-maintained is, because if you're trying to leave, you want to be sure that you have, you know, your oil properly checked regularly. You want to be sure you're keeping half a tank of gas in your car at all times, because there are huge gas shortages. Finding the manual level to release your garage door, because if you have no power and you plan on leaving, you need to know how to do that. Carrying jumper cables and any other important things in your car for, you know, in our environment, we don't need blankets or things for warmth, but we just want to be sure whatever we have in there, just a small toolkit would be valuable. And then you do want to review your home insurance, because if you decided you wanted to take out flood insurance, it takes 30 days for your policy to go into effect. So that's something you would want to review right away with your insurance carrier. So you really want to just be mindful of the preparation mindset. And recently, Time Magazine had an article on how to survive a disaster. So I thought this was really valuable for what we were talking about tonight. And mainly, they came down to several different parts of the mentality of preparation mindset. It came down to an attitude that we can make a difference by being prepared, knowledge, knowing what we need to do to be prepared, anxiety level, we were talking about preparing our children and us knowing that we can come through this disaster and things will be fine. And then just training, practicing. So I know when we were growing up, our parents used to talk about our little fire drills that we would have at our house, that we would practice leaving the house just in case and meet by the mailbox in the front. Mm-hmm. So be in a mindset of training. And one of the most valuable things about this story is about the Morgan Stanley office that was in the World Trade Center. They had a risk management person, and it talks about the power of preparation, that he was able to get so many people out of the World Trade Center because they had all these drills. And of course, every one of those drills was aggravating to these investment brokers, because they were you know, taking time out of their valuable day when they're trying to make trades, and how that really came down to what made the difference for people.
Yeah.
And so we all want to have that same mindset, that what we need to do is be prepared and be trained, so in case of an emergency, we're ready.